Joining me now is Donna Crane, political lecturer at San Jose State University. Hi, Donna. As you know, House impeachment managers are asking President Trump to testify under oath before or during his impeachment trial. A spokesperson is already saying, no, no way, he's not going to do that. Why are they asking in the first place?
Well, I think they're asking for at least three reasons. And remember that Jamie Raskin is a constitutional law professor, so he knows what he's doing here. I think the first reason is just a common courtesy. He's a former president. I think the second reason is for the House impeachment managers to cover their bases, to say that at least they asked, because if the president declines, which he has, then it doesn't leave a gap where senators could say, well, why didn't you even ask for testimony? And I think the third reason is that basically this is there's a no-lose situation here for House Democrats. You know, if the president says no, then he's, you know, does he have something to hide? He's declining the opportunity. But if he says yes, he's so explosive and so unpredictable, and he's taken so many different positions on the question, on questions about the election, that there's no way he could reconcile everything. So that testimony would be sure to be sloppy and not reflect well on him, I think.
So can Democrats force him to comply? Might there be a subpoena? Would they even go there?
Yeah, so, you know, that is possible. Legally, theoretically, that is possible. My instinct tells me, as of today, I just don't see the politics lending itself to that. It would take a long time. It would likely get tangled up in the courts. And I don't see any appetite really from either party to extend this a long time in the Senate. So I would say probably unlikely.
Yeah, some Democrats apparently are not thrilled by the idea of President Trump testifying, saying it would just turn into a spectacle.
Right, there's a real concern that I hear from some members of Congress that the former president could use this as a platform to continue to articulate conspiracy theories and other propaganda that has been adding fuel to the fire of insurrectionists. So, you know, setting aside the question of whether it would become kind of a circus, there is a real concern that he could use it for harmful propaganda purposes.
And, of course, it's considered unlikely his lawyers would allow him to go on the record anyway, especially since the trial is expected to be headed toward acquittal. So I imagine there's a list of reasons his defense team has for saying, you know, don't do this.
Oh, my goodness. I would think any lawyer worth their, you know, their hourly fee would be throwing their body on the tracks in front of this opportunity for the former president. I do hold out, you know, like a 2% possibility that the president might not be able to resist this really high profile opportunity to make his last case. But I do think 98% of me says that he will be persuaded by his lawyers that this is just a bad idea from start to finish for him.
They are, since they are signaling that they wanted a witness, could there be other witnesses, Donna? Do you think that might happen?
Well, there can be other witnesses. The House impeachment managers or the former president's defense lawyers, I don't know that they're exactly called defense lawyers, but his lawyers, could present evidence in the form that sort of we're familiar with it, like what appears in a courtroom, or could call witnesses. At the moment, I'm hearing that there's not a lot of interest in that because it could significantly lengthen the time of the trial, and the Senate is very eager to get to other business. But that is possible, and that is something that I'm going to be watching closely along with lots of other people over the next 3 days.
Yeah, you will not be alone. All right. Donna Crane, as always, we so appreciate your time. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, Catherine.